It's one thing to just tell people what's going on and you can check it out yourself, make your own decision.
But, I mean, what do we do? I'm the same as you. You call me. What do we do? What do we do? Raise our kids good. Be good, decent people.
Now they're going to shut up our bank accounts and lock the cities down and say we're not essential and come force inoculate us. They knew we were making the right decision. They knew we were turning back to God. They knew we were awakening. And so they pulled their Antichrist, Mark of the Beast crap. And all I can say is don't get intimidated by it. Just get angry and say no to it. And I know that's been the solution. And it's also been the problem. Because I've been mighty pissed, man. I mean, they got Muslims tearing down church crosses everywhere. I mean, just evil's on the march, folks. It's running around with its tongue hanging out. Just, I mean, the left is just absolutely out of control everywhere. They are conquering us right now because we have been asleep and because we have been passive. You know, I haven't even gotten into the COVID-19 news. Oh, it's incredible. You know, their whole lockdown system. But look, do an overhead shot of these faces. Look at how Joe Biden, Hunter Biden, they do these fake smiles all day. They laugh, everything's fine. It's all a big joke. You know, you look at the lady that did the debate against Trump, looked like a demon the whole time. But it's just, these people are obviously demonically influenced. And so I just want to ask listeners, what is it you're going to do against this here in the home stretch? Because it's not that Trump's perfect or Trump's going to save the world. But obviously, the demonic forces of the New World Order, these soulless jerks, we're going to completely take over society, completely take over civilization. And so all I can say is, now is the time to stop complying with them. Now is the time to stop bowing to them. Now is the time to stop going along with their political correctness and their mask wearing and their forced inoculations. Like, you go to any restaurant now, they want you to scan the QR code of the menu because they're getting you ready for contact tracing. If you're not a good globalist, you can't be in their restaurant if you haven't had inoculations. And I saw this a few months ago. I went and looked it up, and sure enough, big corporations in the UN are running that and saying that and getting you ready. You try to go to a major park in Austin, and they've got plastic up at the entrance saying you've got to sign a form to go out this park. They're just training you that you live under martial law. It's authoritarian. It's sick. And, yeah, they'll have some young park worker doing it. So you don't want to be mean to her, some 20-year-old girl. Or some, you know, 20-year-old guy. But you need to be mean to them and the system itself, because compliance with this is destruction and enslavement. And I'll tell listeners again, it's not some head when I'm here on air and I tell you that when you spread the word about the show and you share the articles and the videos, it bypasses the enemy. We got a Band-Aid video. Can I show people something? Go to Band.video. And right up at the front is the headline here. I'll show you on this. I've been trying. If we just go to Band.video, you click right there. Confirm, Trump has footage of Hunter Biden raping and torturing little girls. Look that for me.